Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to telescopes.net. My name is Dr. D. Daniel Mouncey, aka Dr. D, also known as Dr. D. You're probably wondering where that name came from. One day I'll tell you that story. Ladies and gentlemen, we have the Maxutov Cassegrain. It's well loved and well hated by many observers. We have the Refractor, well loved and well hated by many astronomers. We have the Newtonian Reflector, ladies and gentlemen, which is loved and hated by many astronomers. Now, let me tell you a little bit about each one of these telescopes and tell you how to utilize them to their fullest potential. Okay, let's discuss the Maxutov Cassegrain. Light enters in from the front, comes off the primary, bounces back up the secondary, then back to another diagonal that's back here. Let's see, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I can't remember the amount of reflections, but I'll have to think about it. Okay, now we have the refractor, which has the simplest of light path. Light goes in, it's bent, and converts into the diagonal, up and into the eyepiece, ladies and gentlemen. The Newtonian reflector, best bang for your buck. Now, light enters in from the front, reflects off of the primary mirror, back to the secondary, and into the eyeball. Be careful, don't point any of these telescopes at the sun. These are specially made to look at night. What else do you want to know about these? Deep sky objects. Okay, Maxutov Cassegrain, 3.5 inches in this particular case, is a great little telescope, very sharp, but it has limited objects you can look at. All the bright objects which are close to us are very large, which means there's a limited amount you can see in the narrow field of view of Maxutov Cassegrains. But they're wonderful for looking at stars and planets and very small types of objects, craters on the moon, etc. The refractor is a wonderful instrument. It has the capability to give you vast vistas of the night sky and the Milky Way. ICC 4665 in Ophiuchus looks stupendous. The Pleiades cluster in Taurus looks beautiful. Wide, you can see it all. Stars situated in various areas, very beautiful. The Newtonian reflector. It's a very popular telescope, collects a lot of light to see those faint galaxies, comes in sizes of 20 inches, 15 inches, 10 inches, and they're not expensive. Now, as refractors get larger, they become more cumbersome and very expensive and very awkward to look through because you have to get lower to the ground to look through them. On the other hand, Newtonians can sometimes be very tall and very high, very frustrating sometimes because you have to use tall stepladders. But let me tell you, it is the stairway to heaven because when you see the galaxies in the full high res, it just looks amazing. The Cassegrain. Let's discuss this. It's a popular telescope because it's so portable. Take the focal length, it's all folded back and forth, but it's good. It's a popular telescope. It comes on little go-to mounts. I just have a little tube assembly here to illustrate to you guys how the different tubes are relative to one another. You can utilize different magnifications with these telescopes. That means that all you have to do is take various eyepieces, anywhere from 4 millimeters all the way up to 30 millimeters, inch and a quarter eyepieces. This one's kind of neat. This refractor comes with a 2-inch star diagonal with the 2-inch, inch and a quarter adapter. It's by Explorer Scientific. Now, I have to be careful of the things I say about this because Scott Roberts could get real violent and get angry at me. So, we got a fine focuser here. This is really nice. If you want to get nice, pristine pinpoints, you just utilize a very fine focus here. We have the adjustable dew cap. We have the provision here to allow you to put an 8x50 finder on here if you want. We have the 2-inch star diagonal with 2-inch, inch and a quarter adapter, which means that you can utilize inch and a quarter eyepieces or 2-inch eyepieces. I mean, the sky's the limit with this thing. On Newtonian reflectors, you can get 2-inch eyepieces as well. However, the demonstration model that I have here is limited to inch and a quarter, and of course, the Maxutov Cassegrain that you see here only allows you to use inch and a quarter eyepieces. However, there are various apertures of all these telescopes available, and you can use these with 2-inch eyepieces, and you can use these with 2-inch eyepieces. Did I make myself clear? Absolutely.
I can be a Russian. I can drink my vodka while I'll explain these telescopes to you.
Or let me just tell you the differences of the telescopes. Newtonian reflectors, best bang for your buck. Listen, if you want to look at planetary nebula, if you want to look at globulars, if you want to look at galaxies, I highly recommend the Newtonian reflector. It is probably going to be the best way to gather your light, to get your photons, to stimulate those eyes, and get you stimulated in astronomy, and get you all excited. I mean, that's what it's all about. Refractors, on the other hand, tend to be a little bit limited in their aperture. And the prices just become insane as the apertures increase. Now, this is a very affordable refractor, but they're limited on their aperture, so they're limited types of objects that you can see, but they do produce beautiful vistas of the night sky. The Maxutov Cassegrain, on the other hand, these are very popular telescopes. They come in the form of what is referred to as a Schmidt Cassegrain telescope. They go anywhere from 5 inches all up to 14 inches, 16 inches, very large. But those are like observatory class telescopes. You're going to be limited to your ability to carry them. After about 11 inches or 12 inches, they become too cumbersome and a little unwieldy. But you do get a lot of performance in a small tube assembly, ladies and gentlemen, and that's what's so cool about it. One disadvantage of them is that they do have long focal lengths, which means that you're going to be looking at a part of the sky that's the size of a postage stamp. Very limited, ladies and gentlemen. So you got to factor in all these little things and weigh these things out when you're choosing between these telescopes. Because it doesn't matter which telescope I tell you about. It doesn't matter if you like the Newtonian, there's always somebody who's going to hate it. It doesn't matter if somebody likes the Reflector, there's always going to be somebody who hates it. And it doesn't matter if you like the Cassegrain, there's always going to be somebody who hates it. Visit us at telescopes.net. Or you can call us toll-free at 888-427-8766. Dr. D out.